We've been all through the UK, and we've had some pretty loud crowds, but I know it's gonna be nothing like Manchester. I need it quiet. We're gonna see how loud you can be. I need it quiet. Shh. That's not quiet. That's not quiet.
Quiet, JR.
This is your moment, England. Are you ready?
Oh. There's the question!
No! Manchester! I said! Oh! Then, for the thousands in attendance, for the millions watching at home, and I just don't have anything else funny to say this week.
Oh.
It's a lot of pressure coming up with something new every week. It's a lot of pressure.
King.
Let's let him hear this worldwide. If you're not down with that, we got two words for you.
I think they're definitely down with it.
Now, we've made a list. We're going to go through it. Vince McMahon, check. Shane McMahon. Check. Eric Bischoff. Check. That's right. Check. You see, Eric Bischoff, or as he's now known on the street, Teabag.
Oh. Explain that to you later, JR.
Eric is like all those other authority figures who thought they could tell DX what to do. It turned out he just had his head up his own ass.
No.
Well, actually, that's not entirely true. It actually wasn't up his ass. It was up, well, take a look.
Big Dick Johnson, it's again.
You know, let's see that again, but this time in slow motion.
Oh, no.
Oh, look at all that jiggling. Oh, my. Those look like two big sesame seed buns.
Picture's worth a thousand words, King.
tough.
That's controversial, and it creates cash.
I think Sean's about to lose his lunch.
Sean, you okay?
I think I threw up in my mouth a little bit.
No.
Well, so now that just leaves Siegfried and Roy. Oh, I'm sorry, Edge and Orton.
This is not Edge and Orton. It's Mr. McMahon's executive assistant, Jonathan Coachman.
Oh, you two can forget about Edge and Randy Orton tonight.
Uh-oh.
You see, Edge and Orton are getting a rematch for the World Tag Team Championships tonight after you two screwed them out of those titles last week. And to ensure that that doesn't happen again,
Hold on. Let me.
These UK fans are having some fun.
Now, I'm just going to go out on a limb here because you were just about to ensure something, and I was just going to say that maybe you were going to once again ban DX from the building.
I mean, it only makes sense. I mean, that worked out so well last week, Sean.
It's been panning out well for you thus far.
Guys, no, really, tonight it's absolutely the contrary of that. You see, you two can stick around just as... You two can stick around just as long as you like, but I have a gut feeling that you won't be sticking around all that long. You see, I've issued a bounty out on you two. That's right. I have secured just over 5,200 pounds.
He's issued a what? Bounty. Bounty.
And guys, that's the equivalent of 10,000 American buckaroos, baby.
Hold on a second. Oh, wait a minute. Did you just say you put a $10,000 bounty on us?
That's right.
You cheap bastard. You're telling us we're only worth $5,000 each? No way. Come up with some more money. I don't care what you got to do. I gotta open a lemonade stand or something. I don't know. Bake sale.
Triple H, listen. $10,000 is more than enough to have a long line of guys more than willing to do what I asked them to do, to take me up on my offer. And you know what? Four of them are going to get that shot right now. And quite frankly, I don't care if you two are not dressed to compete. That's not my concern. What I am concerned with is getting a referee out here right now.
Right now? What's Coach getting to? Well, there's the referee, but...
And guys, here are your four opponents right now.
The thing is a handicap match.
And it's right now. Whoa, wait a minute.
What a mess of humanity is. Are one of these men going to be $10,000 richer? We'll find out next. So sack.